I actually sent him a bunch to you interviews on season 2 of Paranormal Lockdown, so
maybe they'll show up there, maybe not.
So this has been like my passion since doing Shepherdstown and where I'm at right now. So
yeah.
So I just talked to Chief King and he said that there's still stuff going on there. He was saying he might have to bring us back. I'm like, all right, well, there's a few places in Shepherdstown that we didn't actually get to investigate. Like, I would love to investigate Miller Hall. We talked to so many students in Shepherdstown, and that is the one thing that they always talked about was Miller Hall. And honestly, I didn't think really fault lines were a serious thing until I talked to the students there in Shepherdstown. They use them all the time there. Dana always talked to me about the woods in Shepherdstown. I'm like, okay, what's wrong with the woods in Shepherdstown? But I'm telling you, you should go there later. There are some things lurking there that have clearly never walked this earth in a physical human form. So down in the basement, the season finale, everyone's told me to have this episode. I watched it too for the first time because, so I was down in the basement and I remember standing in the corner of the basement by this well. And all of a sudden I started getting like flashes of imagery of this woman and her baby. And I think what happened was, a lot of people don't know it, I gave birth to my daughter literally right before we went into Shepherdstown. And I think that this female spirit like was attracted to me because of this similar situation and she was missing her baby. Woo, it's weird to talk about. No, it's fine. So I remember seeing these flashes of imagery and then that's it. I don't remember anything after. And apparently Bill came down. This is what Bill and Nick tell me. Bill went up to get Nick. I had been down there for about a half hour rambling on about how I did something wrong and I can't leave my baby, I can't leave the spot where I'm at and how sorry I was. And he apparently went to Nick and he's like, dude, you have to go downstairs and get her out of here. So the last thing I remember is going upstairs and sitting outside in front of Nick, and it was like this cloud just parted. I started coming to, and I just had like tears coming down my face, and I was like, it didn't make the show, but I was crying to him, and I was like, Nick, it's not supposed to be like this. Like I don't want people to see this. Like, this is very personal for me. Like, and I didn't understand what just happened, but yeah, it was a very intense moment. Second time in my life that something like that has happened to me. The first time was a very similar situation. We used to do work with paranormal clergy, and it was a really serious case up in Vermont. We actually had to go back to this house twice. Same thing happened. It was like a change of energy in the room, and then I just blacked out. It wasn't until I got out of the location that I started coming to again. So yeah, exactly. Out on the porch, I started coming to again. So yeah. All right, my time's up. I'm so sorry. We have more questions now.
Make your way to my table.
All right, thanks, guys.